So with the central limit theorem, things become really easy. Take our coin flip. There's a true probability P for the coin. Now we know that we sample the coin n times and compute from it our empirical mean using the formula you well know, that it's well true that it could easily happen that P doesn't equal mu. And that's because flipping the coin a finite number of times gives us just an estimate of the true probability P. Now, how likely are estimates? So suppose this is a true P, and I give you three possible mu's. This one, and one out here. And I put little check marks on it underneath. Check the box that is the most likely mu we might observe if P is the true probability using our statistical estimator. And of course, it's the nearest one. In fact, the most likely one will be P itself. And the further out you are, the less likely it is to have a sample that gets you this far out. And now we'll be using the central limit theorem. For large n, say n larger or equal to 30, we know that the distribution of mu's you might observe is Gaussian. For any value here, let's call this one A, the chances that we observe a mu that's smaller than A is the same as the surface area under the Gaussian over here. That's a trick you haven't seen, but the probability of deriving any mu is at least in the limit given by the height of this Gaussian. So for any value A, we can compute the probability that mu becomes smaller than A. And by symmetry, for any value B, that is, say, equally away from P as A is on the left side from P, we can do exactly the same thing. Now, where does the 1.96 come from? And here's the trick. 1.96 marks the 95% confidence interval. So we plug in the observed mu instead of the P, which we don't know. Under the central limit theorem, we get the same Gaussian. And then we compute the x for which mu minus x or mu plus x give us these decision boundaries, such that the total area in these two tails over here is exactly 0.05. That's the same as 5%. In fact, we place half of this on the left side and half of it on the right side. When that's the case, the confidence interval itself carries 95% of all possible values for P. So the chances that P lies outside the green confidence interval is 5%. Hence, we call it a 95% confidence interval. Now, let me ask you a quiz. Suppose you go from 95% to 90%. Does this make X smaller, larger, or will there be no change? Which one is it?